So the topic will be the topics will be the history of Triton, some of the technical principles behind Triton, how we intend to protect the users from wrongdoers, and some words about the content. The history of Triton. So it all started just like in the Silicon Valley fairy tales, into a small student dorm. It was made by, it was at that time called Tiny ERP. It was created by Fabien Parkas and Anthony Le Suisse, which are now the CEO and CTO of the famous Odoo. Things that no one can say the name and so on. The embryo was created while they were at the university. It was written in a dynamic and very easy to use and learn language, which is Python. The license at that time was GPL v2 or later. You will see through the slides that the licenses change 3 or 4 times, I don't remember. And at that time it was mainly used by auction use houses, because in fact Fabien's father was and still is operating one of the biggest auction houses in Belgium. And I think he's still using Odoo or whatever to call it now. Later, when he gets out of the university, he dropped out, he successfully had his diploma. Tiny ERP grows, and the braid was really nice, in fact, but she had some hidden boys. So Tiny, the company, was created around 2004. It sells service on Tiny ERP, the software, to auction houses and to all the other companies that were the one to dare to use it. I think that Timbra was one of the first to do it. I know that because, in fact, I'm employee number 3, I guess, from Tiny ERP, or 4, don't remember. At that time, the code was kept on a private subversion instance, and later the subversion instance would be open to partners of the company, but only to partners of the company, not to anybody. It was made like that at the time, a bit contrary to the other ways that were done for GNOME or KDE and so on. And at that time, the Tiny ERP gains one of the first big technical feature, which is the model inheritance. It was developed mainly by Gaëtan de Menten, Fabien and me. In fact, we have thought about that a long, long time. And in one night of coding, just like usual, Fabien took all the code, rewrite everything, put some bugs, fix some issues, okay? And then he pushed it to the subversion without having a code review or nothing, because at that time it didn't happen. Then the fox is in the hen house. Here comes Robin Hood. At that time we decided to quit the company, me with Gaëtan and Emmanuel Delscol, because we had some technical disagreements on the way stuff were done, stuff were managed, and so on. And we had business disagreements on the way he was working with his customers, in fact. I remember one day I went to to a small city near my house in Belgium. And the whole accounting has been completely rewritten in one night. That's something that happens at the time. And so everything was broken. And I arrived quite confident about the work I had done the day before. And nothing worked. So that's when the coin fall, and I realized that I have to leave, because obviously the customer was not happy, and he said, okay, you can go, I don't care, goodbye. At that time I was responsible for hiring people, and so I feel bad about leaving Fabien alone. And so at that time, we hired first Bertrand Chenal, which is not here, but he's the president of the Triton Foundation. And then I recommended Cédric Hillet, which is there. Because this guy had written to me an email using MUT, so you never know who will read your email letters. And I know that when I read someone who writes to me an email with MUT, I kind of trust him. And so I recommended to Fabien to hire Cédric, but he didn't want, because he's just an architect engineer and that's not good. But in the end, he had to hire Cédric, because we left, and so Cédric was hired at that time. I remember that maybe 3 days after Cédric was hired, he proved his capacity to fix bugs in code that were really unmaintainable, stinky, and it was really awful at that time. And I remember that during his training he was fixing bugs, and I was on the side of him. And he said, hey, there's a bug there. And I said, yes, of course, there's a lot of, in fact. And he said, okay, I will try to search for it. And in my head, I was thinking, yeah. Good luck. It will take time. And at the end of the day, in fact, the bug was fixed. So that's great. Then I left, so I don't have much to say about this part. But at that time, the more things change, the more they remain the same. The whole code could be deployed could change overnight because of commits. The business model has become more and more like MySQL AB, so it's the dual licensing stuff. The migration script that at that time were written, and I still think they do it, but I don't know, they were still not published, and they are still not published. In fact, there is a whole community project to upgrade from version 1 to version 2, and not version 1, but version 7 to 8, maybe 8 to 9, 9 to 10. It's called Open Upgrade. And it was a bit difficult to work with the editor, but now it seems to be settled, this issue. And there is the non-invented ear syndrome that was creeping everywhere with copies of the libraries into the repository and so on and so on. And so we arrive at 0 AD in the Triton world. Cédric and Bertrand left, and they started on the 10th of December 2007, the first commit of Triton. The first release was 1 year later, almost. And since then, there's been a release every 6 months. And it's important to have fixed release plans so that people can plan the migration ahead of time, instead of having software that is released when it happens, you never know. Usually it's around June because they have their huge event on July, but you may not rely on this. The first release had multiple database support instead of just supporting Postgres. Anyway, people are using Postgres, but it's always good for the quality of the code to be able to run on multiple databases. And some of the modules, in fact, all the modules has been completely reviewed from the business point of view. And there were already 18 modules at that time with accounting, sale, purchase, and stock. So people could already use it. And more importantly, there was the principle that P2CK should not be the one company above all the others. It should just be one of the company in the Triton project, not the big company editing the project, and you have to go there to get to use the software. So afterwards, we arrived to the inception of the foundation. It happened 5 years later, yes? So it's a Belgian foundation. It's called Fondation Privée Triton. It's a foundation because in Belgium we have this kind of legal status which allows to put some protection on some projects. They have to follow their goals, and if they don't follow their goals, anybody, anywhere can sue the people managing the foundation to get them out of the foundation and let the foundation go back to their root principles. Those principles are the to develop and support the conferences, meetings, and community activities of Triton, to hold and administer the Triton.org infrastructure, and to organize the community of the Triton supporters, and to manage and promote the Triton trademark. Because B2CK had the trademark at the time, and we gave it to the Fondation Privée. So, this is the first and current foundation board. So there's Bertrand Chenal, who's not here because he's waiting for his wife to have a baby. He's in Belgium. There's Cédric, there's me. Then there's Udo Spalek, which is in Germany. Albert from Nantic in Barcelona. Sebastian, that is there. And Sharon Thomas, which is somewhere between India and the United States. It's not really clear. We are standing on our own 2 feet. The code has been almost completely rewritten since 5 years? No, 8 years. We have removed the workflows because they were inefficient, slow, and so on. We switched to an active record pattern. We have made use of Python SQL instead of writing SQL queries into the code. Some newcomers have arrived and they have never heard, in fact, about Hadoop before. It happens. We are more and more hearing people talking about big implementations, like in hospitals, like in stock management, with big foods and they know them. And some governments are interested in deploying Triton, either under its primary form, so as a stock management or as a framework to develop applications. We are in fact going to Laos to do some consulting stuff about that. They are interested, and we will see if it goes further, but it's in good shape. And also the CNUHEL Savata, which is quite important because it's implemented into Jamaica in, I don't know how many hospitals, Louis knows better, maybe five implementation, I don't know, Jamaica.
Yeah, it's growing, but it's supposed to be nationwide. It's a long-term project.
It's a long-term project that should be nationwide one day or another. Well, some verticalizations are popular. There's obviously GNUHEL, which is hospital management and electronic medical records. There's Cohog. It's a French company that does life insurance management with Crichton. And there are miscellaneous web shops, which there's Neroid, which is maybe now fulfilled. There are people rebranding it, but I don't know if we can say their names, but we know that they are using it, and probably other implementations elsewhere. And kind of life is a bed of roses for now. We have learned to love the tranquility of a stable environment. There has been no license change. Well, if you knew or follow Odoo, you know that there has been a lot of changes in the license, and it makes always once every 2 years a big fuss and a big ado. And there's good reason for why there is no license change, because some authors would not allow to change the license. That's the first part. And because Odoo has some part of the code under its copyright, and I don't think they would allow to change the license. Maybe they will, but I don't think. There is, as I said, predictability in the release process, in the migrations, because we include migration scripts from one version to another. And the community is not tear apart by conflicting business models between the stakeholders. Anybody in the community can do the business model they want. If they want to make a verticalization and hide that it's Triton, okay, it's perfect. No, maybe it's not perfect because they shouldn't make some publicity and so on, but if they want to do so, we will not be suing them or something. If you want to collaborate completely and be completely open, it's your choice. In the end, you just do what you want to do. That's maybe why we are not fighting with a big company that imposes something to others. So, after this long trip through the history, I will talk about some of the technical principles behind Triton. So if you know Triton, you know that if you type import this in the Python shell, you will have a lot of small motto. And we try to stick to the Zen of Python motto. So beautiful is better than ugly, which is obvious. Explicit is better than implicit, and so on and so on. But that's kind of obvious sometimes, but it's better when it's said. So there must be something explicit is better than implicit. And it's not always easy to follow them, but following them make good code. You want to make a photo? A picture? I don't know. And we try to apply those principles to Triton. So we try to be right. So for example, we are using decimals when we make computation with amounts, instead of having rounding issues. We try to use dates We have not a problem, we are losing. We're using dead time, and it's not always obvious. We are using simple and flat design instead of having nested designs. We try to reuse existing libraries, so for the reporting we use Relatorio for evaluating code entered by users, we use simple eval. There are some stuff that you cannot do, but it's not important. And when libraries are not there, we create them, so there is Python SQL now, Google Calendar to have the calendar and to the Triton client. And we try to follow Python, so now we are using only Python 2.7, and there's an effort to use Python 3, which is blocked by pwebdav, but yeah, maybe we will remove webdav or we will use something else. And we provide a migration path from one version to another. So for this, that's the point, without Fento locking, which Luis will talk about in the future. And so there's also the process to ensure the quality. The code review, which we don't have enough people doing. And I know because I'm one of the people that should be doing it, but I don't do it enough. We have unit testing, and Cedric will make a talk about all the unit testing infrastructure. But to automatically run the test, check the coding guidelines and so on. If you ever made a review for Triton, you have probably received an email from the bot to tell you that you have not followed the paid and so on. And we have blueprints and discussions on the design on the mailing list, or before that on Google code, but it's dead now. We try to use reusable components. We are trying to make sure that the modules are extensible by working as much as possible on the line level and by splitting the computation in small logical components. For example, if you take the way we create the shipments in the sale module and the way we override it in the sale shipment grouping module, so it's a module to group the shipment by sale or other criteria, you will see how we split the computation in small parts that can be overwritten into another module to just do what you want. And now the somehow legal part, how we protect the users from the wrongdoers, because we've seen that sometimes the wrongdoers are the company at the top, the editor, and sometimes wrongdoers are from elsewhere. So, we use the GPL V3, that's the main protection. The GPL provides the four freedoms that I'm pretty sure you're used to, so the freedom to run the program for any purpose, the freedom to study the program, the freedom to redistribute copies of it, and the freedom to distribute copies of your modified versions. It's not always obvious, because some other ERPs are making steps into other directions, but that's the way we do. And it's also a copyleft license, so when you have those rights, you have to pass them to the others. That's simply put, oh, what is a copyleft? Then there is a question that is raised once, maybe two in a year, about what license a module should be using. So my opinion on that is quite the easy one. It's that it's a difficult question, and we are not lawyers, so it's difficult to answer. But it all rely on the concept of derivative words, and you should consult your lawyer. We have one here. And some must be GPL, other can be anything, I think, and even proprietary if it's a big enough development. But I'm not sure. Consult your lawyer. We don't have a CLA. A lot of projects have a CLA, which a CLA is a contributor license agreement. It defines the terms under which you contribute to the project, who has the copyright, and so on. Usually, you give your copyright to the company. We do not require people to sign a CLA, because we do not believe in CLA, so CLA. We don't want to give too much power to the company deciding to receive the copyrights. That's one of the things. Also, it makes the contributing process easy because you have to sign a paper, fax it, or I don't know, send it by email, I don't know. And also, people can contribute anonymously because if they sign, you know who they are. And that's not something that we want. And so the community. So, as I said earlier, there is the Triton Foundation. The problem that was raised was that P2CK could become evil. And we could start to use Triton to make a lot of money out of the people using Triton. Somehow. Because we had the copyright, or a big part of the copyright, and we also had the trademark and the infrastructure and so on. So amongst the company there was a growing concern from former OpenERP partners that we might turn like Tiny. So we created the foundation to host all those things. And so the fact that we given the trademark and so on, and that the copyright of the on the code is shared by a lot of people, it's also a protection against a coup somehow by P2CK. And now the trademark issue is solved because the foundation has it, and the triton.org domain is now also in the end of the foundation, and so there is no issue that if we want to become evil, Triton can go on without us, and voila. So I briefly talk about why a foundation. And in PageJournal, they must have a selfless purpose, I forgot to say that. And we, as the founders, cannot gain material gain from the foundation. And as I say, anybody can sue the board if we are not gentle. The foundation has also a kind of democratic structure. We have the foundation supporters. They are recognized for their involvement in the Triton communities. So anybody can ask to become a Triton supporter. But the board vote on who became a supporter, and it depends if they are involved in the community or not. Usually just submitting a patch or asking a question in the mailing list, or being known by coming to conferences is enough. And this body of people, they represent the Triton community, and they have the power to remove directors from the board by making a vote at the two-thirds majority, I guess, or something like that. It never happened. And anybody can become a supporter, so either a company or an individual person. We are here in the Triton Conference. That's one of the main gathering of Triton developers. The conferences are made to open discussions, and instead of having a fixed schedule and everything is tight and not easy, the conferences are rather relaxed and anybody can speak if anybody wants to speak, so that's what we do. There has been 4 conferences for now, in Liège twice, then Barcelona and Leipzig, and now it's the 5th one in Buenos Aires. Usually we have the code sprint, so you're all invited, and they are used to put name on the nicknames and so on. And obviously we enjoy the local beverage and foods. And the next one is now. Ah, it's over. Questions? If you don't have, it's not a problem. I'm thirsty, so I'd like to... Hola.
Wow. Yeah, I have one very unpolite question, because you have mentioned that P2CK can become evil, yes, and can somehow start to make a lot of money charging the users of Triton.
Yes.
But I want to ask a very simple question. How does P2CK maintain itself now?
By selling services to people using Triton.
Okay.
I have another unpolite question.
We starting.
I have another unpolite question.
Yes.
I think you did not do any risk mitigations. That means you took the same plane.
Indeed.
Just in case the plane crashes, how will we make sure that Triton can survive?
That Triton is alive.
That Triton can survive. I mean, you guys are the main developers. Why, if something happens, which we do not hope, but just in case.
Triton is not only B2CK, it relies on the community, and so...
We don't care, we will
not be. Indeed, we will be dead, so it's not our problem anymore. But
up to the foundation.
It's not really the foundation, it's the community. Anybody can be involved and submit patch, and... We have committers that are not here, they are in Barcelona, in...
But we are missing... indeed, we are missing some technical guys for the infrastructure to maintain. For now, we are only the two having... Any access to the host, the machine, but it will be great to have other people involved and they can share access and provide more security.
Yes, indeed, we should send the credential to
someone in case the plane crash. But yes, indeed, the community can... I guess if we disappear, someone will rise up and be more important than he is now. But it's not guaranteed. The only way to guarantee that is to have more contributors.
And probably put it in some sort of umbrella, like, you know, a larger organization like FSF or something that can take care of all the technical infrastructure, or
Yeah. It will. That's not the kind of stuff that makes the project alive. It's having people involved in the development.
Well, development is one part, but also you have to maintain all the, as you said, you know, we need some people to take care of the Mercurial server and those type of things.
Yeah, we should have.
Me oyeron, no?
Before the retro.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Just like the Eagles say, just for the record, we never broke apart, we took a 20 years vacation. No, what I was suggesting that it might be a good idea somewhere around the line to put the Triton project be part of maybe, I don't know, Free Software Foundation or something like that. That they take,
or GitHub maybe.
Or Python, yes.
GitHub.
No. No. Because at the end of the day, as you said, we are developers. We don't really want to spend more time on maintaining the infrastructure or putting money into servers and all the security things and things like that. I mean, it works very well now, but I don't know if the project keeps on growing the way it is growing, which is great, maybe we can just say, well, you know, talk to these guys or whatever organization. What I'm saying is there are some free software organizations there that we can just say take care of all these parts and we
put the focus. I don't know if the whole infrastructure can be under the umbrella of the Free Software Foundation, for example. And there's the migration of this and so on. So we have our own infrastructure and I'm not that involved into the infrastructure, just a bit, but not that much. But I don't think it requires a lot of investment. Just having someone that can tidy up and do the usual stuff.
Indeed, one thing that is important is that we decide when we want to upgrade some part of the software and to decide for the plan of the infrastructure. Because otherwise you depend on someone else and they make the change whenever they want. And if it's, for example, just before you are starting to make a release and get that difficulties and so having our own infrastructure is in this way better.
And it's not the main part. If we crash, the problem will be, I guess, the developers. Not really, because a lot of people are relying on Triton, and so I guess they will step up, as I said, and get more important and more involved. But the infrastructure is just more a side problem. Another question? Okay.